Students, today we have to start the new lesson in the geography, Indian Forest Resources. So, what is meant by forest? Actually, a large area or a large land covered with a tree and the undergrowth. It is covered with a tree and undergrowth. Undergrowth in the sense, still they are not grown up. Okay, plant. Okay. That they are called as undergrowth means nothing but plants. Okay, large area covered with a tree and the undergrowth is called as the forest. What are the importance of forest actually? The importance of forest, let us know. Yes, forest provide the wood because a large wood it is there in that, and also it provide the timber for the industries. The timbers are the raw material for the industries. I think you know about that, is it? And make them to that timber used the by the persons or by the peoples for the furniture like that. So that is why that has timber as provided by the water forest only. And it also provide this timber and everything. The industry is running. In industry, many of the peoples are working. So that's why forest provide the employment opportunity also for many members. It provide the employment opportunity, and also it increase the fertility of soil. Soil fertility has increased by the forest actually. Yes, it has increased because I think you know about that. In a forest, many of the organic matter will be decomposed in the sense decaying. So by that, the fertility has increased. And also forest provide the shelter for many wild animals. It provide the shelter for many wild animals. Many wild animals are living in the forest, and also it maintains the ecological balance. Ecological balance is very important. It is okay. Ecological balance in the sense, yes, many of the animals are there. Many kind of animals are there actually in a forest. As you know that they are the herbivorous and the carnivorous. Carnivorous eated the herbivorous and maintaining their balance. Carnivorous eaten by some other carnivorous, they maintain the balance. So like that, it has maintained the ecological balance. So these are the importance of forest. Very important question. So what are the importance of forest? Forest means the area which is covered with a tree and the undergrowth is called as a forest. Forest provide the wood, timber, etc. And it also provide the employment opportunities. Forest provide the raw materials for many kind of industries. Then forest increase the fertility of the soil. Forest provide the shelter for many wild animals. And it provide the ecological balance. Along with that, forest provide the many medicinal plants also. Many of the medicinal plants will obtained by the forest. I think you know about that. Ayurvedic medicines will obtained by the forest. Okay. These are the importance of forest. What are the types of forest? There are the 6 types of forest. Types of forest. Which are those types of forest? Let us know. There are the 6 types of forest. First one is tropical evergreen forest. Tropical evergreen forest. The second one is tropical deciduous forest. Tropical deciduous forest. And the third one is scrub forest, and also as well as grassland. Scrub and grassland. The next one is desert vegetation. And the next one is mountain forest. And the last one is mangrove forest. This is the mountain forest. And the last one is mangrove forest. So these are the kinds of forest. Let us recall once again, which are the kinds of forest? Tropical evergreen forest. The second one is tropical deciduous forest. Third one, scrub forest as well as grassland. And the next one is desert vegetation. The fifth one is mountain forest. And the last one, sixth one, is mangrove forest. These are the kinds of forest we found in India. So let us know in that the first one, that is the evergreen forest, also known as the tropical evergreen forest. Okay, so why it is called evergreen forest? Actually, this forest, the trees are always green. Ever in the sense always. The trees are always green in all the season. In all the season, in the sense summer, winter, or rainy, in all the season, they never dries up. The trees of this forest are always green, and they found in the tropical area or the tropical region. So that's why it is called as the tropical evergreen forest. Tropical in the sense, I told you already, not too hot or not too chill. ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಶೀತನೂ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಉಷ್ಣನೂ ಇಲ್ಲ. ದಟ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಟ್ರೋಪಿಕಲ್ ರೀಜನ್. ಕೀಪ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದ ಎವರ್ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಟ್ರೋಪಿಕಲ್ ಎವರ್ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಶೆಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಲೀವ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ದಿಸ್ ಎವರ್ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಶೆಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಲೀವ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಟ್ರೋಪಿಕಲ್ ಎವರ್ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್. ವೇರ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದಿಸ್ ಟ್ರೋಪಿಕಲ್ evergreen forest, we can see in the Western Ghats. Western Ghats in the sense, you know about that, right, already. So the coastal region along the Arabian Sea is called as the Western Ghats. The coastal region along the Bay of Bengal region is called as the Eastern Ghats. Okay, next, they are found in the Western Ghats, Assam, Nagaland, Meghalaya, Tripura, Manipur, Andaman and Nicobar Island. Totally, this tropical evergreen forest found in the heavy rainfall region. Which region? Heavy rainfall region. What I told, now they are all called as the heavy rainfall region. Okay, so which are those? Western Ghats, Andaman and Nicobar, Nagaland, Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura, Manipura. Okay, so in these places we can see the tropical evergreen forest. Next, the second one is deciduous forest. Okay, yes, evergreen forest, I told you already, they never shed their leaves. But deciduous forest, they shed their leaves. Shed means elayana bilsutte. Which forest trees? Deciduous forest trees. But the evergreen forest, they never shed their leaves. I mean, elegalanna avu bilsodilla. So that is called as the evergreen forest. Deciduous forest means they shed their leaves. That is called as the deciduous forest. Yes, if they are asking you the question answers in the examination, why the deciduous forest are called so? Yaake deciduous forest na aa reethi karitare antandre, because they shed their leaves. Okay, they shed their leaves in which season? In the spring season. I think you know about that. Leaves, everyone, they are fall on in the which season? In a spring season. Spring season is also known as the autumn season, right? Is it a So that's why they are called as the deciduous forest. Where we can see this kind of deciduous forest? The deciduous forest we can find in the our region only. We can find Karnataka. Yes, almost all the trees are they shed their leaves, right? Okay, in Karnataka, Maharashtra, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, and foothills of Himalaya. Foothills of Himalaya in the sense, I think you know about that. These are all the deciduous forest we can find. These are all the moderate rainfall region. So in this area we can find the deciduous forest. In which area we can find? Particularly in Karnataka, Maharashtra, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, and the foothills of Himalaya region. These are all the which rainfall region? Moderate rainfall region. Yes, the third one is scrub forest and the grassland forest. I think you know about that. Scrub in the sense that mullu gidagalu elli irthave adana scrub forest anta heltare. Okay, so that is called as the scrub forest. Actually, they are not grown up for very tall. Actually, they are like a bushy type. Okay, scrub forest, and also the grassland, also where the in which area the grass is cultivated. They are all comes under this kind of forest, which is that the scrub and the grassland. Okay, so where we can see this scrub, okay, almost the scrub in a sense, I told you already, bushy and throny plants. Throny plants are grown there, that is called as the throny in the sense mullugidagalu. Okay, so that is called as the scrub forest. So where we can find that? Rajasthan, Punjab, Western Ghats and Cardamom Hills. So there we can find the scrub forest, Rajasthan and Punjab, Haryana, and these are all, keep in mind, this is also one of the desert region actually, but not completely is a deserted area. So there we can see the scrub and the grassland vegetation. Okay, and where we can see the desert vegetation, desert vegetation, almost in a desert, I think you know about that, there will be the low rainfall. So in a desert, completely in a desert, it is not come scrub forest, not found in complete desert, but desert vegetation we can find in a completely in a desert, I mean low rainfall region, completely in a desert area we can find the desert vegetation. So where we can find a desert, the plants which are grown on the desert area, that is called as a desert vegetation. So where we can see, that is Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan and Deccan Plateau, or in a one word, desert vegetation we can find in the low rainfall region. Desert vegetation we can find where? In a low rainfall region. That thing you have to keep in mind. So the next one is, after desert vegetation, the next one is mountain forest. I think I already told you, I think so, the mountain area is very fertile, right? Because due to the decomposition of organic matter made that area as a very fertile actually. So what is meant by mountain forest? The trees which are grown on the slope of the mountain. I think you know about that, mountain area is not a flat, it is like a slope, right? Is it a, the trees which are grown on the slope of the mountain, that is called as the mountain forest. So where we can, which are the trees particularly grown in the mountain forest? The trees are oak, chestnut, oak, 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 which are the trees of mountain forest. Oak, chestnut, these are the trees names, okay? Oak, chestnut, ash, pine, ash, pine, okay? Fir, deodar, deodar and walnut. So these are the important trees we can find in the mountain forest. What is mean by mountain forest? The trees which are grown on the slope of the mountain is called as the mountain forest. That thing you have to keep in mind. And the last one, that is the mangrove forest. Okay, what is mean by mangrove forest? That is very important. The trees which are grown on the wet marshy area in the river deltas. Wet marshy area, marshy area in the river delta, river delta in the sense river sides or river beaches, okay, river delta is called as the mangrove forest. Very important. What are mangrove forest? And I've almost repeated, the trees which are grown on the wet marshy, marshy in the sense kesaru tumbida jaga, jaugu pradesha anta heltaru, okay, kesaru. So the trees which are grown on the wet marshy area is called as the mangrove forest. So that thing, or on the river delta, river delta in the sense river sides of the rivers or river beach, that is called as the mangrove forest. Okay, so which are the important mangrove forest? The important mangrove forest are sundari trees. Very important. Most of the mangrove forest are sundari trees. Okay, sundari, then screw pipe, palms, canes, etc. Palms, canes, etc. So these are the example for mangrove forest. Okay, and I told you the important mangrove forest are sundari trees. To grow for the sundari trees only, there will be the one particular area in a Ganga Delta that is called as Sundarbans. That is called as Sundarbans. Very important. So what is mean by Sundarbans? If they are asking, the Sundari trees are grown in the Ganga Delta. I told you, river delta, Ganga Delta. I mean next side of the sides of the Ganga River. Okay, the Sundari trees are grown more in the Ganga Delta. So that's why that area is called as the Sundarbans. Which trees are more grown there in a Sundarban? Bun in the sense not what you are eating, that bun it is. Bana means Kannada word, it is a kadu. Okay, Sundari maragalu tumbiruvantaha kadanna Sundarbans anta heltare. Okay, so the Sundari trees are grown more in the Ganga Delta region. That area is called as the Sundarbans. Keep in mind. Okay, why does Ganga Delta is called as the Sundarbans? Because Sundari trees are more grown there. Sundari trees are the example for mangrove forest. What is mean by mangrove forest? The trees which are grown on the wet marshy area, that is called as the mangrove forest. So tomorrow we have to discuss about the next continuation part in the lesson. Till that, keep learning. Thank you all.